Do your students get nervous when they have to do speaking activities? Or do they have problems speaking in front of the whole class? Well, I've got a tool that's going to help your students practice their speaking at home in their own time, and you as a teacher are going to be able to give them the feedback that they really need. Hello, welcome back to my channel, Charlie's Lessons, and in this video, I'm going to share with you my experience using Microsoft Flip. Before we get started, thank you so much to all the members, both on my YouTube channel and on my website, charlieslessons.com. Your support is really helping me to produce more videos like this. Also, I want to say a big thank you to Paul, who gave me my very first super thanks. I mean, I didn't even know these things existed, and suddenly it's there. So I was really happy to see this, and it was my very first super thanks. So thank you a lot, Paul. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take a look at how Flip works. So I'm going to give you a little tutorial if you haven't used it before. And then I'm going to show you some of the ways that I've been using it with my students. So when we get to the Flip's main website, once we've logged in or made an account, so on the left-hand side, we've got camera. So in this case, I'm using my laptop, so I'd have access to my webcam. We've also got mixtape, so we can mix various videos from both ours and the students, and also videos. These are exclusively my videos as the teacher that I've recorded for my students. Then below this, we can create new groups, and you can see already that I've got a couple that I've already made. If we click on my profile icon in the top right hand corner, we've got some more settings. The one I want to show you though is called Discovery. So if we go here, you're going to find a lot of example prompts or topics. Now, topics in Flip are like just questions that group various videos together. So if you've got various videos that are answering the same question, these are all grouped by what Flip calls a topic. So for example, let's look at this popular topic on the right here. It says, what do you think? And it's asking you to read an article that's titled, Let's Get Rid of Cell Phones. And so what's going to happen is students have 1 minute to argue about what their opinion is on the topic of this article. If I wanted to use this topic, I would just need to go to plus and say add topic. So to make a group, which is the first thing you're gonna need to do, you're just gonna go to this plus sign and go to create a group. And then it's very simple, you just need to choose the grade level. In my case, I just chose all ages as I was gonna use it with teens and adults as well. And I went to next, and then I just have to enter a group name. I can also choose a background. Think of it like Google Classroom in a sense. Just like that, the group has been created. And once you've created your group, you've got a couple of options to start adding your students. So you can give them this link right here. You can share it by Google Classroom or send it directly to the students via their email. You do have a decision to make here. You can either allow people to join anyone who has the link, or you can have an extra setting, which means that once people get the link, you still have the opportunity to approve or disapprove that they join the group. Once the group has been created, you can still edit the group. If you go here, you can actually change the image to a custom image that you have on your computer, and you can decide who has permissions to create topics. The next thing we're going to take a look at is how we make topics. If we go into our group, we can see here on the right-hand side, we've got this plus sign that says topic. We're going to click on here. And again, much like the group, we've got a couple of options on how we can customize our topic. So obviously the first thing we need to do is ask our students a question. So for example, do you like pineapple on your pizza? I mean, obviously everyone's going to say yes, because it's the best thing you could have on a pizza. Once we've got the question right, we can add some description or some more context. Now, I think this is probably not so important in this topic, but if your topic is a bit more complex, then you might need to add some more context or guidance for your students. And then down below, we can add some images, media, some emojis, even a video that's gonna just give our students some extra context. So the next thing as well is recording time. So this is obviously really important for your students. I think it's really important that the students are given ample time to answer whatever question you give them, especially if they are lower level students. So they need more time to really think about what they're going to say. Now, there are a few settings that are really important for you to see right now. So the first one is this little checkbox right here that says submit to educator. Now, this is one of the best things about Flip. It gives the teacher lots of controls on what can be submitted and what can't. We can turn this on, and whenever students submit a video, we're also going to have the opportunity as teachers to make sure, is this video appropriate for the rest of the students to see? So we've got that turned on, and the next thing I want to show you is if we go to settings in the top right hand corner, I really like platforms that don't require students to make accounts, because I always find whenever I take technology into the classroom and I've got to get every single student to make an account, which means they need an email address, which means they need access to the email address, sometimes they've forgotten their password, this is a really nice option. So we just turn this on, and now this means that a student can give a video response as a guest. And by setting a password, we've now removed the necessity to create an account. One thing that I noticed is that you don't need your students to join the group. You can actually get them to join the topic through that guest password, and you can get your students submitting video responses strictly through a topic and through a guest password. We're gonna go to record, and you're gonna need to give it access to both your camera and microphone. And you can see here, I'm recording my video, and this is me too. We can either do audio. So again, this is great for your students. If there are students in your class who are really shy and a bit reticent from appearing on camera, so you can just choose audio. Here on the right-hand side, we can add some text. We can draw, we can add some stickers, we can add a GIF, we can even change the filter. We can also add these lenses. So something like this is perfect. Again, students who are a bit maybe self-conscious, who are not really happy with seeing themselves on the camera, something like this, I'm very happy for my students to do, because really the most important thing is that they are speaking and I can hear them speak and I can give them feedback on what they're saying. If the student and the teacher goes to the left hand side at the top, you can get to see the topic again, so students can remind themselves about what it is they actually need to speak about. Also, something else I really like is this board feature at the side. So if we click on the right hand side, board, as a teacher, I found this really useful because I was, as you'll see in a moment, I was giving my students some feedback on vocabulary and pronunciation errors. So when the student's happy with all of these features, they're just gonna click the record button and they can start speaking, and that video will then get submitted to the topic. Before I show you the first way I use Flip in my classroom, I'm gonna give a big shout out to Christina. This is Christina's blog right here, and her full name is Christina Cabal, and this is her blog, and she's got lots of really cool ideas for English language teachers. And it's not only about technology, there's lots of ideas, lots of lesson plans, and it's all free. And she also does really cool workshops. This was a really big inspiration for me to use Flip in the classroom, and I want you to go check out her blog and also her ideas for using Flip in the classroom. So the first idea was to use topics based on questions from video series on Vogue's YouTube channel called 73 Questions. So what they usually do is they go into a celebrity's home and they have a list of 73 questions to ask a famous celebrity. And so what I did was I chose Taylor Swift for my class. And what we did first was, as per Christina's lesson plan, I got my students to watch the video with Taylor Swift and make a note of any questions that they liked that they would want to ask their classmates. So in this example, I've got 5 students that were in my class, and each of them created a topic that had the questions they wanted to ask. And then the students joined those topics and recorded their response to that question. So for example, here we have a question from one of my students who asked the rest of the class, what was the last thing you baked? Now obviously I'm not going to show you these videos because I haven't asked my students permission, but if you can go down to the bottom here, we had 3 responses, and the students could watch these videos and respond to each other's answers as well. And this was done on the very first day of class, and this was a really nice way to get my students to get to know each other. The second idea is one that I use with one of my students who's preparing for the Cambridge proficiency exams. Some of you may know who have worked with the Cambridge exams is that one of the parts in the speaking paper is describing photos. So here is my topic. You can see here very clear, speaking practice describing photos. I've got the instructions as per the exam, and I've also got here on the right hand side, I've got the photos that were used in this particular speaking exam. And so to do that, all I did, as you saw before, when I created the topic, I could add images. So I just took the image from the speaking exam and uploaded it onto here. Now, I'm not going to show you the response from my student, but I am going to show you my response to him. So here is my video response to his first video. You can see here on the right-hand side, I've isolated some vocabulary that I thought he had some problems pronouncing. To do this, remember, I recorded my video and I selected board, and I split the screen in half, and I also added some text there. So you can do this whenever your students give you their video response. You can respond with your own video and you can give them feedback like this. Well, there were two examples of how I've used Flip in the classroom. Now, I hope that I can inspire you to use Flip in your classroom with your students, because I think it has a lot of benefits. For example, in my case, I had a student I only see once a week, and giving him this opportunity to practice speaking skills outside of class was really beneficial for him. And also, remember, for students who are a bit nervous, a bit shy about speaking in class, perhaps because they don't want to do it in front of the other students, then this is also a great tool for them. You can give them speaking tasks to do at home where they feel a bit more comfortable, and you can give them the feedback they need, as you saw I did with my students. So thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you next time.